decision dates need to be customised for each individual property. The Meat and Livestock Australia GLM Edge packages focus on three dates. The first is in the middle of the wet season or growing season. The second is at the end of the growing season or wet season. And the third is in the middle of the non-growing season. Those are our three decision dates.
We schedule our decision dates basically going into our season, so into our wet season and also going into our dry season. Decision dates are when we're going to make key decisions on the business. So have we had the rain? Has our season come? Has it come on time? Have we got enough feed? Decision dates are very important. If you're not organised going into a season, you're not going to get as much money for your cattle. You're not prepared with feeding. Do you have enough grass in the paddock to see your cattle through that year? Do you need to offload stock? Can you potentially buy stock?
In the monsoonal north, we classify it as an official start to the wet season when we've received 50 millimetres of rain over three consecutive days between the months of September and March. In the more arid regions of northern Australia, the amount of rainfall might be less, or the number of days in which it was required to fall may be longer. If you haven't received your official start to the growing season by the middle of the growing season or wet season, our decision date one, that means it's unlikely that you're going to be able to grow as much pasture as what you usually would. The conditions will deteriorate. The amount of pasture, of course, determines how many head can be carried on the property.
Decision date one, so our first decision, is based around the wet season. We're looking for storms around November, December. So our key decision date is going to be in January. Like, if we have not received adequate rain or enough rain, we know we're going to be in a bit of trouble and we're going to have to do a lot of juggling around with numbers. It's all very easy to make decisions when we have had a really good start to the season and we're in the thick of our season in January, but there are some really hard questions you've got to ask yourself and your business, you know, to get through those dry times, which we have seen in the last sort of 8 to 10 years. So if the season hasn't started or is not adequate, we look at what stock we have on hand and see, are we overstocked? What markets are we going to meet earlier in that year?
The second decision date should fall on a date when historically the rainfall stops. For some beef producers, this might be the end of March. For others, it might be the third week of April. Either way, this is a really good time to construct a forage budget.
Decision date two is based around when we predict the wet season to finish. So ours finishes around that sort of March, April. At that point in time, the season should be starting to wind down. We're looking at where our grasses are, how much growth has there been through the wet. So we're going to the paddocks, looking at the pastures, doing a budget and working out what can we run.
If the wet season doesn't come or starts to fail, I think you have to manoeuvre fairly quickly. And I believe that is an extremely critical time in the business as far as ground cover is concerned.
It's really important to match your stocking rate to what pasture you have in your paddocks. You don't want to get halfway through the year or towards the end of the year with a late season and realise, oh my goodness, I don't have enough feed. What am I going to do? A good wet season brings a lot of opportunity and a lot of relief. When your season starts on time and finishes when it roughly is meant to finish, or it's extended and that cold wind stays away, it gives you a lot more options.
It makes a person that does the books, which is my wife, a lot happier person, and which naturally makes me a happier person. So it just helps overall. It helps your character, helps the business.
The Future Beef YouTube channel has a number of videos featuring Cole Payton, who explains how to do a forage budget, and of course are accompanied with a number of electronic templates that anyone can use and download for free. We also have the Stocktake app, which will step users through the process.
Decision date three is in that middle of the dry period. And this country here, and a lot of country that, you know, the frost and winter rain, small amounts of winter rain, can do a terrible lot of damage to the protein levels in the feed. And I think that, you know, they're decisions that if the market is good, you offload cattle, move early, and don't wait until the stock lose condition. Every time you wake up in the morning, you're making an assessment of and looking at the weather predictions and the charts and things like that, to what track you're heading down and what decisions you possibly got to make. If you underestimate, that means you've sort of got more grass on hand than what you thought. Now, if that be the case, it's a good thing. Better than the other way, if you've got more grass in your paddock going into the wet season, you're then going to get more moisture retention in the soil, and you're going to get a better pasture growth out of that. If you've overestimated, and I think most people have been through that, which doesn't make for good ground cover, and I think that it's imperative that we do a budget and we leave plenty of ground cover. But if we haven't got ground cover, what will happen is when we do get our rain, you won't get a response, because by 9 or 10 o'clock next day, the sun comes out, the moisture's gone.
My advice to other producers is you really need to sit down with your family or whoever you're running the business with and make those decisions. And the decisions that you've made previously, have they been correct? What could you have done better? If you don't make those decisions, it makes it extremely difficult to A, sleep at night, and B, make money. And to do that, you need to be looking after the country that you own or the country that you're running and your cattle. You know, you need to be looking after the welfare of your cattle. And when you do that and you get it right, you do make money and you can sleep at night and it feels good. Not making a decision is a decision in itself, and it just doesn't work.
If beef producers would like to know more about setting decision dates, forage budgeting, or working out the potential economic impacts of the decisions that they are making, they should get in contact with us or find out more at futurebeef.com.au.